Hello,
fellow
scientists.
Echo!
Echo! Have you ever wondered how sound travels from one place to another, or how it's created in the first place? Well, in this lesson, we're going to explore... we're going to learn... I don't think we're alone in here. Let's try that again. By the end of today's lesson, you will be able to describe the cause of sound, explain how our ears allow us to sense sound energy, and describe how sound travels. Let's get into it. Sound is a form of mechanical energy, meaning it relies on motion. Whether we call it noise, music, or a raucous cacophony, sound is always created by one special kind of motion. Vibration. Vibration is a rapid back and forth movement. It can be so fast, sometimes you can't even see it. You can observe for yourself how sound is vibration. If it's comfortable, put your hand against your throat and hum. What do you feel? Pause the video here and describe your observations in your guided notes. No matter your level of musical talent, you should have felt a kind of buzzing feeling in your throat. That's vibration. Ears sense sound energy by being very sensitive to vibrations. When a sound reaches your ears, like the sound of my lovely voice, the vibration causes a special part of the ear, called the eardrum, to vibrate as well. The vibrations in the eardrum set off a reaction that sends signals to your brain saying, "Hey brain, listen up, there's a sound here." Your brain then interprets the sound, deciding if it was a barking dog, a car alarm, or the ice cream truck driving off before I had a chance to get my money. Hey, wait! So, sound energy is vibration, and our ears allow us to sense those vibrations, providing us with an important way to interact with our world. How did the vibrations coming from the truck down the street get all the way to my ears? Well, sound energy travels as vibrations moving through matter. Let's take a look at what that means. To create a sound, the speakers on the ice cream truck vibrate. That movement causes the matter around the speakers to vibrate too. What matter is around those speakers? The air. As one particle of air vibrates, moving back and forth, it bumps into the next particle, causing that one to vibrate, knocking it into the next particle, which causes it to vibrate, and on, like a row of dominoes, each knocking into the next. That chain reaction of air particles vibrating and bumping into each other allows sound to travel great distances, including to my ears. Sound doesn't just move in a straight line from the source to your ears, though. Oh, oops. Sound vibrations move like ripples in a pond, expanding out in all directions from its source. That's why you can still hear someone talking, even if their back is to you. Wait, freeze. What sounds can you hear right now? You might notice that sounds with sources closer to you, like your device, sound nice and loud. But what do you notice about sounds that are coming from farther away? Also, like ripples in a pond, as sound vibrations continue to move away from their source, the same amount of energy is spread over a larger area. This means the farther away from the source of the sound vibrations you are, the fainter, or quieter, the sounds will seem. It's not only distance that affects how loud or quiet you perceive a sound to be. Try this out. Take a pencil and lightly tap it against your desk or a table. Listen to the sound it makes. Now, this may seem like a funny thing to ask of you, but try putting your ear against the table's surface and then tapping the pencil again next to you. What difference do you notice? Yeah, you gotta be careful with that one. You probably noticed that the sound of that tapping pencil got a lot louder, more like a hammer than a pencil. That's because sound actually travels a lot faster through a solid than through a gas, like the air. Do you remember the structure of a solid from our unit on matter? The atoms are packed tightly, super close together. Because they're so close together, when one atom vibrates, it's able to knock into a lot of other atoms super easily, like billiard balls at the beginning of a game. So sound vibrations can travel very quickly through a solid. The atoms in a gas, on the other hand, are super spread apart. So it takes more time before sound vibrations cause one particle to bump into the next. Sound vibrations travel the most slowly through a gas. That's why the sound of the tapping pencil sounds much quieter when it has to travel to your ears through the air. So, because of the way their atoms are organized, sound travels fastest through a solid and slowest through a gas. Based on that information, how fast do you think sound can travel through a liquid? Pause the video here and jot down your thoughts in your guided notes. Let's review everything we've learned about sound energy today. Sound is a form of energy created by vibrating matter. Our ears sense sound energy when sounds cause our eardrums to vibrate, sending signals to the brain. Sound travels by vibrating particles of matter bumping into each other. Sound moves in all directions away from its source, and it gets quieter the farther it travels. Sound moves slowest through a gas, a little faster through a liquid, and the fastest through a solid. To learn more about sound energy, be sure to check out the practice questions and activities that go with this lesson. Based on how quiet the sounds of those bats were, I'd say they're pretty far away. That means we can finally talk about how sound vibrations bounce with echoes. Let me demonstrate. Echo! Vibration. Justin rocks. Is this thing broken? Justin is the best. I have to go figure out how this cave is warping the laws of physics. Until next time, remember, science is all around us. See you next time. Oh, come on! Hey.